When it comes to Medicare, it's like alphabet soup. There are more letters than you can shake a stick at. Part A is hospital insurance. Part B covers doctor's visits. Part C is referred to as Medicare Advantage plans, which cover costs not paid by Parts A and Part B. And then there's Part D, prescription drug coverage. Most people haven't heard about Parts G and N. Those letters are not technically part of Medicare. They fall under the heading of Medigap, or Medicare Supplement Insurance. Now, no matter what company you choose, all policies are standardized, meaning Plan G with one company will pay exactly the same amount as Plan G with another company. The only difference may be the price, which can differ from one company to another. All policies offer the same basic benefits, but some offer additional benefits, so you can choose the one that best meets your needs. There are 10 different Medigap plans, but companies are not required to have all 10. I'm not going to cover all the policies here, but let me show you two of the most popular, Plan G and Plan N. Medigap Plan G requires you to pay a small annual deductible. After that, Plan G provides full coverage for all the gaps in Medicare. It pays Medicare Part A coinsurance and hospital costs, Medicare Part B coinsurance or copayments, the first 3 pints of blood if you need a transfusion, Part A hospice care coinsurance or copay, skilled nursing facility coinsurance or copay, Medicare Part A deductible, Medicare Part B excess charges, and foreign travel medical emergencies up to certain limits. It does not pay the Part B deductible. Part N is very similar to Part G. The difference is that in addition to paying your Part B deductible, you also pay copays for doctor and emergency room visits, plus any excess charges. Excess charges are any costs above the Medicare-approved amount for a procedure or service. Providers who participate with Medicare accept the Medicare-approved amount as payment in full for covered services. It's always a good idea to ask a provider if they accept Medicare assignment. Unlike Medicare Advantage plans, there are no options in Medigap plans for prescription drug coverage, vision, dental, or hearing. If you want that coverage, you have to purchase it separately. It doesn't mean that Medigap plans plus those options are more expensive than Medicare Advantage with those coverages. Just a different way to manage your medical care. The issue is, what meets your particular needs? The best time to enroll in a Medigap plan is during your open enrollment period, which is a 6-month window beginning the month you turn 65 and are enrolled in Part B Medicare. If you're already in a Medicare Advantage plan and want to switch to a Medigap plan, you can only change during the Medicare Advantage disenrollment period from January 1 to February 14th, or during the annual election period, October 15th to December 7th. But keep in mind, if you want to switch, you lose your guaranteed issue rights. You may be required to provide past medical history, and if the Medigap insurer thinks it will be expensive to cover you based on your health, you may be turned down or you may have to pay a lot more for coverage. Switching is very serious business. There are a couple of links below that will help you as you do your research, what Medicare covers, and how to compare Medigap plans. More useful information is on the way, so subscribe to the Alhambra Investments channel.